As a virtualization administrator, a VMware administrator needs to understand the importance of templates and when to create them. It will allow you to create multiple virtual machines efficiently. Let's get started. This is Ibrahim Qureshi and you're watching VMware Tutorials for Beginners. This is session 8, templates, which we are going to discuss today. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, consider subscribing, because this training is for anyone who wants to learn virtualization and there is no IT background required. So let's get through the agenda for today. As discussed, I'm going to introduce you to the topic today, which is templates. We are going to go through the benefits of templates and how to create a new template, and then how to deploy a virtual machine using a template which we have created. So let's get started. Templates are used for VM deployment, which is deploying a virtual machine. So I'm going to give you some summary here, why we are discussing this. So you, in your organization where you're working, you could have a requirement of having a Windows 2012 server or a Linux server. You basically go ahead and deploy a virtual machine first, which I have shown you in one of my videos previously. So we have gone through the phase where basically we created a VM container with CPU memory and everything which you need to create that virtual machine. And then eventually you install it. Once you install it, you then install the important components which we need in it for daily use. So it could be like the agents for monitoring it. It could be an application which your user required to access on daily basis. Once all the installation is done, we basically can power off that virtual machine and then create a template so that we can use it as a goal template. So this basically leads us to the next topic, which is benefits of the template. So you have used the machine, we can now convert it to a template and make it as a goal template or a goal image in our environment. Anytime you need to deploy a new machine of the similar version or the same version, you just need to use the goal template and you can deploy it, and it will be ready in matter of 10 minutes, depending on obviously how much resources you need or how big the virtual machine is. The template also eliminates the risk of having, you know, configuration issues in your environment. So you will be you will avoid having IP conflicts or duplicate server names, because when we create templates, there is a concept of sanitizing your virtual machine, which for Microsoft they call it sysprep, which will make that virtual machine as a vanilla machine. So when you deploy it, you can then when it powers on, you can then use it as a new machine. You can give a new name and then you can give a new IP and start using it, which avoids any incidents or any conflicts in the environment. The best way, I cannot stress enough, the best way to deploy the VMs is using templates. Also, if you are having more than one virtual machine to deploy, I would suggest you to start looking at some scripting like PowerCLI and using an automation script to deploy using your goal template. So we'll cover PowerCLI in the coming sessions anyway, but let's get started into some demos. So today's demo we are going to go through how to create a new template and how to deploy a VM using a template. Let's get started. In one of the sessions, we created a virtual machine and we installed a Windows 10 OS on it, which we have here. So the best way to create any template is, as I said, create your machine first, make sure you have all the applications inside it, and then power it off. Once you power it off, you can see the machine here as well, but there is a tab here you can notice. It's called VM and template. Click on the tab and then you'll see the machine here. All you have to do to make this machine a template now is right click on the VM and convert to template. And you can see the template is now created and you will no longer have the function to power it on. Now this will become and remain as a template in your environment up until you basically deploy it as a virtual machine again or convert the template back to a virtual machine. All VMware does when you convert it as a template is it marks it as virtual machine as a template. Another important thing to notice from the point of view of the exam and also for your understanding, when we create a template from a virtual machine or when we mark a virtual machine as a template, what will happen is there is a file which will be created. So this is the same test Win10 machine. As you can see, a lot of files which were created previously when the VM was running has been disappeared and you have a new file created called VMTX, which is the extension for a template virtual machine. So that's very important to remember. So remember what is the extension VMTX, that's the extension of a template. So I'll quickly click on another virtual machine and show you the other files which it has. As you can see, this VM is also powered off, but there's no VMTX here. It is having a VMX file and it has other files as well. So hope the concept is clear. So let's go back to the tab, which is VM and template tab, and then scroll down. This is our template. I normally want everything to be organized. So let's create a new folder here. Sorry, here, template folder, and we'll call this templates. Obviously, this is the first template which I have created in my environment. So I'll drag and drop it so it looks a little bit organized as well. And we can see our template is here now. So the next thing this is it, guys. So this is how you create a template. So let's get started. Let's create a new virtual machine from this template. By the way, I didn't cover snapshot so far. It's coming in the agenda, so it's going to be in the coming sessions. I'll be covering that anyway. Okay, so let's create this VM as test template VM for one. Why not, right? Select the data center where you want to deploy. So this is going to be a Windows machine, but I'm going to put it in here in discovered virtual machines first. Select a resource where you want to deploy it, which is this compute. Okay, and you'll see that it is compatible and checks are succeeded. Think it's a thin provision machine, but it's just so that's about it. As you can see on the left here, we are deploying a new VM. Click next, and that's it. So when we click finish, you'll be having a running Windows operating system. So as you can see, the VM is now completed It's been deployed and it has taken tests. Obviously, the disk I have is a slow disk where I deployed it, so it has taken around about 15 minutes. So this is the new virtual machine which we have installed now. I have started another deployment on the SSD hard disk in the background to compare the time difference really. So let's power it on and see this virtual machine. Okay, it's powered on, which is good. Remote console, open it. There you go. You can see it loading Windows. I see the Windows icon there. Over here as well. So that's how quickly you can create a virtual machine using template. And so far we have covered how to create a template using an existing virtual machine which you have, you know, customized it fully and made it a gold image of yours, and then basically we make it, convert it as a template, and then after converting as a template you can deploy it like this. Let's quickly show you how to change it back from template to a virtual machine. So right click on it. If you right click on this one, so you have certain options here. So clone to template, clone to library, and also you'll also see convert to virtual machine option. Now it's grayed out at the moment because there's a deployment running here. So once the deployment is completed, I'm sure this option will be enabled. So we have covered how to create a new template, how to deploy a new template, and I have quickly shown you how to change a template back to a VM. So as always, I would say if you have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter at Ibrahim Qureshi. You can follow my blog, which is ibrahimqureshi.com, and don't forget to subscribe. And the question of the day today is, what is the file extension of a template? So I have stressed this when I was going through the video to make sure you guys remember it. So if you remember it, comment and let me know. Comment on below quickly on this video and let me know what is the extension of the template. When you mark a virtual machine as a template, what is the file extension for that virtual machine? So, okay then. Hope to see you in my next video. I keep sharing. Cheers, bye.